My name is Guy Wallace. I'd like to talk with you about something we call performance modeling. There's two parts to performance modeling. One is to chunk out what we call areas of performance or segments or major duties, key results areas, et cetera, et cetera. You can use many different ways of chunking this out. Sometimes it's quite arbitrary. It could be chunked out a different way, and it really doesn't matter as long as you capture the totality of the performance and minimize gaps and overlaps between your chunks, these areas of performance. This is an example for the most convenient store manager based on some actual work. When you take one of those chunks then, you can do this performance model which contains two parts. On the left-hand side is ideal performance, the first three major sets of columns, the key outputs and measures, the key tasks, the roles and responsibilities. You simply ask questions, in this area of performance, what do you produce? What are the outputs? How do you know when you're done? How do you measure it? How would you know a good one from a bad one? What tasks do you do to produce that output? That's where our task analysis goes. And then to clarify roles and responsibilities, you can articulate in a collaborative environment who's doing what. If it's a single performer, then you can skip those roles because it's just one job. The right-hand side constitutes a gap analysis against that ideal performance. And I often look at the measures for an output and ask, typically, are we not getting outputs that meet those measures and standards if we can find them? If I find what those performance gaps are, if I'm really looking for qualified employees and I'm getting poor choices made and unqualified candidates, however the master performers or subject matter expert articulate that, you can then do probable gap causes, or if you have a lot of time, you can do root cause analysis and make darn sure you're really getting to the root. But if you're dealing with master performers who bail out other performers, often they know what the causes are. And then you contribute those causes back to deficiency of environment, deficiency of knowledge and skills of the performer, or deficiencies of their individual attributes and values. Thank you.